We're back at it again here with another video with Invest for Tomorrow. To all the first time viewers and investors, welcome to the channel. To all subscribers, welcome back. All I ask for in return is for you to smash that like button to let me know you watch this video. Helps out the YouTube channel and lets me know you appreciate the time and effort I put into making these videos. So here we are with AAPL Apple Inc. And this is going to be a huge, huge sense of direction of where things are shifting, okay, what the future is. Okay, we have right now out there the metaverse, and now we have also autonomous driving and electric cars. Those are like the two main sectors right now that are booming, and not only that, are said to be as big as the internet in the next 5 to 10 years. So in this video, we're gonna break down some huge news for Apple Inc. because this was once a rumor and now it's been confirmed, and this was dancing around near all-time highs. And we're gonna break down with 42 Vision how things started to show there was strength a few days ago, as well as what Ultimate 42 Vision is showing. But before we break it down, I wanna share with you guys a home run opportunity you do not wanna overlook that we mentioned this morning over at the Discord. And if you wanna get in on early with us, check out the link down below in the description to the Discord. And by joining, you'll become part of a growing community of investors. We look forward to having you join us. We're going to jump right into it here with AAPL Apple Inc. So the home run of the day was spectacular and beyond expectations, even though the overall markets were sitting sideways or pulling downwards. I will continue to look for opportunities, and this is what we strive for. And today's home run just blew it off the charts. And if you want to get on early with us every single morning, check out the link down below in the description to the Discord. And by joining, you'll become part of a growing community of investors all looking to learn and grow together. So today I only mentioned one stock, and that was LGVN. Now it takes a lot of confidence for me to do that, because usually I'm looking for multiple opportunities to find what is working within the markets. But today I only had one that caught my attention, and this was spectacular, guys. And like I said, this is what we strive for every single day. Now on Ultimate 42 Vision, it sent out that bull indicator. 42 Vision itself showed strength all throughout, and it gave us a highest point of 200% plus at the time of me doing the screenshot. I mentioned it way down here at 335. It ran nearly almost 20% from those points up to like 420, pulled down towards the bell, and just took off, giving a highest point of possibility of 200% plus. And the bear indicator did not pop up and the transition into weakness until way up here near $8 from way down here in the threes, guys. So if this is something that interests you and you want to gain on early with us, check out the link down below in the description to the Discord. We look forward to having you join us. Let's jump into these charts. So Apple starts flying today and yesterday. It's done a staircase effect from yesterday's pre-market into today's and continues to push up higher. And this news might be something to watch going into tomorrow or even the next following weeks, guys. This is beyond just a few days and weeks from now. This is big news, even for the long term and long haul, okay? This is not just a short term information or excitement, but in the short term it might create volatility. We need to see if it decides to cool off or continue this type of strength like it did the last 2 days, where it consolidated into the next day and did another leg up. And we need to see if this is going to decide to hit new all-time highs, okay? Because this had been dancing around all-time highs for the last several days, back and forth, back and forth. Now I need you guys to understand that the bull indicator on Ultimate 42 Vision popped up since the 16th. You would have known about this strength even before this news even came out, just by looking at the charts, guys, because the strength was confirmed since way down here on the 16th, consolidated and continued. And you can see it with 42 Vision. All of these have been green candlesticks, and the weakest ones have been with red borders. Okay, let me show you guys a normal chart so you could see how many places someone would have actually gotten faked out or would have gotten rejected or stated, you know what, I'm out, this is pulling downwards, it's getting weak. And if you're looking at the volume and other indicators, you could have gotten faked out when there was still strength there, because 42 Vision was still green even though there was red borders, and it just continued with the strength, and it was under a bull indication. Okay, the last indication that we got was a bull one. There was a slight bear one from 150 down to 149, and then from that point forward it has been filled with strength. So why is Apple running, and who knew before, right? The only thing we had here before the news was just the charts and all of this strength here with the bull indication with 42 vision, okay? But before that, how did people know this was coming? Well, I'm sure there's insiders and big players in the markets that knew this before it came out, but this came out today, okay? Apple's electric car could debut as soon as 2025, Bloomberg News, okay? Their goal is to create and launch an electric car as early as 2025 and refocusing on the project around full self-driving capabilities, okay? Tesla has a head start against them, but if you really look at Tesla today compared to Apple, it was actually kind of bouncing around, but it's had some strength since the 15th, not the 16th, but since the 15th. And both of these are starting to turn into the large players, not only of the S&P 500 index, but of the EV sector. If you go ahead and look at Lucid, you go ahead and look at Rivian, there's a lot of options now, okay? You need to realize which ones are the top players, because when a bubble of the EV sector does burst, there's going to be the ones like the saying from Warren Buffett, you can only see who's not wearing a bathing suit when the water goes out, right? When there's low tide, not high tide, everyone looks the same. Low tide, you get to see what's going on underneath the water, right? Or underneath the surface. So Apple being in this sector is taking its technological advances and innovation to a whole new level, and is literally telling us, okay, for Apple to go from just phones, okay, and all this type of technology into self-driving cars, Apple's always trying to be ahead of the game or where the sectors that are the hottest to be. And it's been in the hottest sector for a while. It's been with software, it's been with phones and technology, computers, chips, everything you can think of. And now they're getting into autonomous driving. There's something that autonomous driving has that Apple wants to take a market share in. If not, they wouldn't even be doing it. They would continue to focus on what they're doing. So you see here, the demand for electric vehicles has surged as countries and customers turn more environmental consciousness, right? Propelling the market value of the companies such as Tesla and Rivian far above traditional car makers around for decades longer, okay? Things are shifting, and there's a difference here. And Apple is trying to be part of this whole entire picture. And it all goes back to chips as well, because chips need to be in these cars, and then also having the environmental friendly approach, and also the hottest sector that is to come for the next 10 to 20 years or even longer, okay? Now, Reuters had reported in December that Apple was targeting 2024 to produce a passenger vehicle that could include its own breakthrough battery technology. So this news has been dancing around, and the fact that Apple's participating and they're trying to get their first electric car out there and debut it by 2025, I think that's a big move. I don't know if they're trying to try to get a piece of that, you know, infrastructure bill as well, because that is extra cash and literally free money for companies that are participating to go ahead and excel and grow their balance sheets. I mean, there's so many different approaches of why Apple is probably doing this, but to see Apple and Tesla participate, S&P 500 index, largest players, they're in the trillions of market cap. I mean, this is a no-brainer that these stocks are going to be growing for the years to come, but there's going to be some that win and some that lose, and there will be a burst when things slow down, and then they're going to grow for the years to come as well. So that is something to be aware of. So Apple right now in these key levels, the first thing I'm going to be watching is for it to stay above 155. Worst case scenario, 153. We need to see what's going on within those levels. And if it's going to hit newer highs, It needs to break through 158, 159, and we'll have to see how it holds up and how quickly things are moving. I mean, there's a lot of volume going into Apple, and it might be something that will catch more people's attention tomorrow as they're starting to find out about it. And those that really knew were watching it since way back here. And us here with 42 Vision, we were seeing strength, and the bull indicator is an upgrade that's coming soon to Ultimate 42 Vision for all members to have that are in the 42 Vision tier level, guys. So if you guys wanna get clarity in the charts and be able to trade options, trade calls, puts, or just stocks in general with clarity, no more guessing, and focusing in on where the strength and weakness is, check it out down below. You gain access to the Discord, the weekly watch list, and the indicators that bring clarity to the charts. As always, guys, thank you guys so much for watching, and let's make some money.